Well, my name is Ari Hoffmann, and I did a PhD in genetics at La Trobe. I became fascinated by biology at quite a young age. I was born in the Holland, and my father, who came from the country, or the Dutch countryside, really enjoyed going out into parks and also forests. And we would go out there and start collecting mushrooms, and that really captured my attention. And then, of course, we migrated to New Zealand, and in New Zealand we had a farm, a market garden, in fact, growing vegetables, and I really became fascinated by the process of plant growth. And that was also my first encounter with insects, because, of course, we had a lot of pests, and there were beautiful grubs on sweet corn, for instance, and I used to watch those. Yeah, so La Trobe provided me the opportunity to do a PhD. That's where it started. So all of a sudden I'm in this environment, it's a great environment, and I'm doing research. I mean, that was so exciting for me. So I had suddenly found my calling in a sense. La Trobe, of course, has a nice environment. I enjoyed the fact that it was a lovely bush setting you could go to, and the wildlife area that we could go to. There's a nature connection for La Trobe. The department was called Genetics and Human Variation, which was quite unusual. As part of my PhD, I actually selected lines of flies that responded differently to chemicals. And then, of course, I could then use those lines to investigate, you know, the genes underlying those chemical responses. So I really enjoyed that. I really enjoyed thinking about that. And I enjoyed the fact that you can manipulate these things. And as a consequence, of course, ask quite important questions. We had a fantastic lab. You know, we had exciting people in the lab and doing different things. We used to work until all sorts of hours, running experiments in the middle of the night, for instance. And of course, that created a certain level of camaraderie amongst the group. And I remember going out, you know, eating pizzas at 2 o'clock in the morning sometimes. As I was doing my research at La Trobe, I suddenly started thinking about, you know, how can we apply this in a real world situation, you know? And that's when we started coming across some really interesting problems that we eventually helped solve, or at least contribute to their solutions to. So one of the things we worked on, for instance, was grapevine pests, where we used these genetic techniques to come up with some new ways of thinking about and controlling pests. I started becoming interested also in health vectors, and that links back to a discovery I made, which was all about something called Wolbachia. Wolbachia is an organism that lives inside the cells of insects. And I discovered this purely by chance. If you can change the bacterial constitution of an organism through changing what's inside its cell, you can potentially change what that organism does. So it previously might have spread virus, now it doesn't spread virus. That eventually led me to looking at mosquitoes and looking at controlling human diseases by manipulating this particular bacteria. And it's been enormously rewarding, of course, for me to see this bacterium that I discovered back in Drosophila and flies being transferred to mosquitoes, watching it spread, and of course now we don't have any dengue transmission anymore by these mosquitoes in North Queensland. And that's tremendous. And of course that's a program that's now being rolled out around the world. I'm also excited about imparting knowledge. I've trained probably about over 70 PhD students and research master students. And I really enjoyed seeing those people flourish. And they have, you know, many have gone on to do great things. I think as a scientist, you're always learning. And I always set myself something new to do every year. You have to always expose yourself to new ideas and new areas and new ways of thinking. And, you know, we face, obviously, as a society, major problems at the moment. And I think we sort of, as public scientists, we owe it to society to try and make those sorts of connections. I think that's critically important.